Rafting, no. It's really only good like maybe really like April, May is when it kind of gets going. Right now, obviously, we're experiencing the peak runoff, so June is the best time to be here water-wise. And July, August get pretty busy. And then some people stay like into maybe even October through September. After that, it starts snowing. All right, whoever's going to be in the front can go ahead and climb up there.
Webcam guy.
Everybody's on a different beat, all right? Everybody's sitting kind of straight up like this, paddling like this. When you paddle, you really want to be leaning forward, pulling back, leaning forward, pulling back. Lots of body movement. Let's try it again, forward two.
Yeah, get your paddle all the way to the water.
You need to scoot way up, hold up. You need to scoot up and turn to you and kind of sit sideways. Off your foot underneath that. Forward two times. All right, so right now we have no rhythm. Up front, remember that's your job. You guys have to actively watch each other every time you paddle and make sure that we're going nice and together. Let's go forward two times. No, not even close. Come on, guys. Watch each other. Watch each other paddle. Make sure your paddle's going in the water, coming out of the water simultaneously, spearing simultaneously for that second stroke. Here we go, forward two. Better, better, better. I am probably going to need either you two or you two up front to switch sides. Probably you and him. I'm gonna have you guys just switch. No, you're okay. More of a weight thing right now. No, you're good. Yep, I'm gonna have you go up over the left. Are you okay with being on the left? Shoulder issues. Just go forward two. Together at all up front, and I mean, I don't know any other way to say it, but the paddle strokes are worthless if they're not together. Right. And like obviously here it doesn't matter, but when we're hitting a big wave and we're not together, forward two, we're just turning the boat sideways that way. Watch the big bump, big bump.
Bumper boat.
So that's sort of our primary concentration is, are we together every single time we paddle? Every single time. And so everybody has a role in that, okay? We're gonna watch each other, we're gonna talk to each other. You can say, hey, let's go back paddle two. You can say, back paddle two, back paddle, back paddle, back paddle, nothing's happening. So back it up.
We saw back over
you. Yep, sorry. We went from story time to paddle stroke. So anytime there's paddle strokes, that's what we're doing. Let's go forward two. And then let's say I yell a certain amount of forward strokes. And then we only do half of them, and I yell, stop. Stop just totally cancels out everything else, and our paddles just come up out of the water. All right? So what seems to be going on is the right side's got a little bit quicker pace, and I like it. So I want the left side to maybe try to mirror that quicker pace, and Also, you don't have to reach quite as much out to the side as what you are up there. Just kind of steering straight forward.
Oh my god, I get misty. I get misty when a group really gets it, you guys.
Let's go forward two. Oh yeah, that was beautiful.
Forward two.
We got this. Right side one. Left side one. Forward one. Lean in. Boom, yep. So, and I really recommend, like, your weight is actually on your elbow, on this, yep. And don't let go of the T-grip. And then it's real quick. So, as far as rapids go, we're going to make this S-turn. As we bend back to the right, we're going to be right in it for Maytag Rapid. All right, it's just kind of a lot of current pushing onto the left side of the river. And at the bottom is one of the biggest waves we'll see all day. Right? So we have to paddle hard, we have to be together, no matter how crazy it seems or what's going on, just keep digging in those strokes, keep them together, and then at the last second, hopefully we're going to be kind of on the right side of it, and then we're going to kind of turn it in and crush a big, big chunk of that wave, and it can flip about easily. So we want to be, we want to have good momentum and be nice and square when we go in. Forward two. Very nice. If we have to high side, you're literally going to be throwing yourself onto that other person across from you's lap. Like you're literally going to go chest on lap, and you're trying to lay over this tube. What that does, if there's a big wave, and we're all on the side of the boat going into the wave, we'll push the boat down like a surfer, trying to get under the breakers to get farther out into the surf. It's kind of the same thing. We're trying to get underneath that, or the wave has already lifted us up, and we're trying to climb up here and push that side of the boat back down. So those are quick. They're not casual, like scoot over and say hi. It's like get cozy, jump across their lap, and you're trying to do a push up off this other side of the tube.
What does the person do with the cheating ball?
What?
No, it's to be like when they're coming over.
Oh, yeah. We just try not to hit them in the face with it.
Really?
Go forward one.
Go forward two. Oh, just like that. This is called Maytag. This is two guys in the meet, okay? When you hit that whitewater, lean forward.
Forward one.
Forward two.
Forward one.
Forward two. Forward two. Go, 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 go. Right side, right side, right side.
Try to get up on the tube of the boat a little bit and kind of scoot back out there. You actually want to be real up high, like really not on this at all.
Yep.
And I like to dig that other heel back in that crease.
Yeah, that's what I would do.
Point
yeah.
Your toe out.
Then you can kind of sit, yeah.
Do that.
Do a little bit more stable.
Most of the boats only have 2 foot cups in them. This one with four.
Yeah, and I think that's just more for like height related stuff. Needing to change around or wanting a different spot, doing good. Mm-hmm. All right. Let's keep it how it was then.
Forward two. I've got the power.
stagecoach and railroad arrows. Let's go forward too. It's kind of right in the biggest part of the rapid. But if you look on the left side, you might see it down here. Forward one. One more. Switch sides real quick. Just flip real quick. Try it out. And let's go forward too.
Right side, back one.
Forward three.
What do you do during the winter then?
I'm actually a teacher now.
Oh, okay.
It's my second year teaching and kind of finishing up with my alternative license program right now.
What do you teach?
Where?
No, what?
What? I do middle school, special education, mild moderate interventions for like reading and math. Writing in there. It's basically kind of extra math practice with the basic, foundational skills that they need. A forward one. And then I'll push into a lot of classes, like I'll push into the math class and the reading class. Just like extra support. And then they also come to me for like the class. Actually, it's a lot of papers.
Sure.
Not really my strong suit.
Yeah.
I like working with the kids. And I get to do a little bit of coaching. That's probably the most fun.
Yeah.
Coach like a basketball team. Oh yeah. You have the parents. They can make it interesting. Sometimes the other coworkers. Although most of that, I really like the staff that we have. For the most part, it's a pretty good building.
Do you teach around here?
I do actually, yeah, in Canyon City at a middle school in the K-8 called Harrison. It's like swallows, like building mud nests. Like eat the dirt and like regurgitate it and make a little, sometimes we'll pass them, but they're really cool. It's like maybe that big and it's just like a cone hanging under the rock.
And that big like cliff band all the way along there that curves out is like inside of an old volcano.
Really?
Yeah, there's a bunch of dinosaurs and fossils in there.
So. Oh shit. It's called Echo Canyon. Little like valley.
Right here?
Right there. I have actually. So it's close to Texas Creek, and then you take this like dirt four-wheel drive-ish road, and it comes to like this creek. I mean, it's followed the creek for a couple miles. A lot of some cattle grazing and stuff like that in there, but other than that, there's really hardly signs of anybody.
I think now I'm going to be staying at Texas today.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll be riding tomorrow.
Let's go forward, too. Something like that would probably be a high side situation if we were to, like, especially where the water's really pushing up on it right here behind us. Crawling from the right side of the boat like we were gonna run up that rock.
Yeah.
And watch that T grip when you lean in, just use that. Just make sure you don't get it. Let's go forward, too. We have no rhythm. We gotta watch each other up front. Forward, too. Nice to get there. If you gotta wait 1 second, that's fine. The timing is probably less important than the rhythm. Right. We're starting to get to where we'll be heading into Three Forks. One of the biggest bends anywhere on the river that I know of. Just makes this huge sweeping, almost like a horseshoe here. And then right as we are about to come out of it, we'll come into Three Forks. They call lean in there. Some of those, there's a couple kind of ledgy waves that can really give the boat a bounce. So be ready for those. Let's go forward one.
Some of the biggest stuff you've ever hit.
That I've ever hit would be like the gorge right now. When it's closed, it closes at 3,200 cubic feet per second. We're about 4,700 cubic feet per second, which is crazy. It hasn't gotten to the 5 grand range, I don't think, since like 2014. It got pretty high a couple years ago. I don't think it got as high as this. Let's go forward too. Yeah, and it's not done. Who knows, it could be getting started. I anticipated the gorge being closed for a month, at least. I think it's been at least a week or more already. Yeah, we did.
No less.
I think it was Saturday. We did like one in the morning, and then it was done by the afternoon. Let's go forward two. Here we go. Forward two. Dig it in. Partially because we got an extra person more than he does, and that weight kind of makes a difference. When you get down in the current, just a little bit more with the hook in the current, you're going to go a little faster. I want to start right on in here. Like both of those rapids, we ended up forward one. Forward two.
Forward. Forward one. There we go, that's good. Forward two, hard.
together. Forward, go, forward. Stop, right side one. Woo!
Decided he'd make the board air chamber and put holes in the bottom.
go forward too. And so that air just floats up and all the water runs out. A lot of rafts are still glued in for the hold. These are laced in.
Yeah.
So it's really like, it's got a lot of room for that water to bail out real fast.
Yeah,
yeah, it's like a bathtub. Like for a second I like was down in here, like my leg was under there. There was like this much water. That was awesome.
I know!
So you think the guys
my elbow, from, obviously.
You think the guys from Oxford made it in their homemade raft?
No.
No?
Let's go forward too. What's that rhythm though? Keep the pace.
That water is about as cold as next year.
Right?
Oh, what's hypothermic?
We're headed into this little rapid next call. So we can call it snowplow or bootleggers, Bigfoot. It's pretty good right now. Let's go forward too. And then we go right into Truck Street Rapid, which is one of the ones you can see real good from the road coming in. Big ol' wave.
Two. Woo!
Next up, we have double dip. Well, sometimes it's almost like two little rapids, and I call the top one single dip. But right now, it's all just pretty much one big wave change. Once it gets like July, then it's really crazy busy.
Yeah.
This is when I want to be out here, though, because the water is so great. Yeah, it's going to last longer than usual, but it doesn't last long, you know, compared to the rest of the year.
Sure.
Let's go forward, too. So it's kind of special. Forward one. Thank you. one. Forward two. Recovery area though, it's pretty much one big wave. So if you swim, you're just gonna go straight for the right bank. It might even just put you there. And then listen to the kayaker. I think we'll be all right though. They might provide some entertainment for us. Let's go forward one.
Forward one.
focus on that log and almost fell out too.
Happens quick, man.
Yeah, that's a big one. Kamikaze is no joke.
We took one to the team.
Hey, that actually might have saved us. Yeah. That's definitely like turning into the low side. And if people fall off the low side, it's kind of the same as high side.
Well, I was up here on the front and it was coming up like this, so I kind of grabbed him, pulled him to me.
Nice.
I know.
I'm used to it.
Pretty doable.
3 weeks
kind
ago.
Of a technique for you guys to really like pop yourself. Like, I almost like push myself down a little bit.
Like CFD.
Slide, and then everybody wants to let go of that red strap right away and try to throw their arm in the boat. So just keep that red strap until you're all the way arms are straight. Yep, and then you can just kind of dolphin kick. Now let's get around this rock. Let's go forward two. Go for it if you want.
Oh, right now?
It'd be a little easier actually on this side of the boat. It's good, you won't be fighting the current trying to pull you under. Go ahead. Boulders and you got big flat areas, and then I've seen it up to 6,400 or something like that.
Was it right now like 4,000?
No, it's like 4,700. Wow. Crazy high. Some years the gorge doesn't even get to closure, and that's 3,200. That's really when it starts to get big.
So do you get pretty disappointed when the river goes down and it's not as fun anymore?
Yeah, you can say that in a way. But at the same time, I just try to get as much as I can in now because I know it could be, you know, 4 years or something before I get to see it.
Right.
Last year, we didn't get very high. They had a little bit of runoff early, but then it was pretty much gone. 2012, though, and 2002, those were significant drought years. 2012, I think the average was like 300. Most days, like by the end of the season, it was like 200 for a month and a half.
Do you guys lose a lot of business when the river's down then?
A little bit. It was a little slower. I don't know. It's hard to say. Because sometimes, you know, some people don't want to do it when it's high, so they'll only come out when it's lower. Other people get scared, you know, if we make the news or something, and they were on the fence about going whitewater rafting, that'll make up their mind for them.
Right.
And you got other people that, you know, they see it on the river, they see it on the news, the high water warnings, they're like, yeah, let's go rafting. You know, it's hard to say really what affects the business the most. But I think right now it's the timing. I think another couple weeks, the weekends will start being crazy, and then in another couple weeks, as soon as we get close to 4th of July, it'll be like a bus after that. Mm-hmm. This is Brian, who's going to take our picture. Sit up in the front, and then lean in a little bit in the middle, and lean in a lot in the back. Make sure, nope, in the front, sit straight up and out, so that we can see everybody's face. Maybe, hold on, maybe scoot out a little bit. All right, we're
there
good.
There you go, good. 1, 2, 3. Thank you, guys.
Do you have to pay for those pictures?
I do.
How much?
I think you can choose one for like $20, or you can get them every one I take for $60. It's usually like $200 or something, huh?
This many boats, maybe like $100 and something.
Okay.
Oh.
Believe it or not, that's not a waterproof camera.
That's what I was just
really?
Ask.
Yeah, they trust him a lot. Yeah, he has like a Pelican case, so it's like a little box, waterproof box. And he's kind of in there like this, and so that box sits right here. And it's, they usually like strap it to a cam strap like around their waist or something so they can get out. And then he just has to pull that skirt up, pop the box open, he can take the camera out, and then puts it back in, snaps the skirt back on, and keeps going down with it. No, really, I think the only company that does a kayak photo program.
Yeah.
We used to be one or two, and a couple companies at high water will at least send kayakers down for safety, because I mean, they're really the ones that make it. Without them, like, the swimmers go so much faster. So if someone fell out in current, we could paddle hard and maybe not catch up to them, as well as a kayak. They're like a high-performance motorcycle. We're like a big minivan. And they can just zoom, that torpedo shape, they just kind of strength to weight ratio, they just kind of slice right through the water. And
are you ready to swim ashore?
Yeah, they're good.
They're all waiting.
They knew that something was going to happen there.
Have a good time.
I
can trip
over. That was a bird for a second. I just saw it out of the corner of my eye.
Like, is it any... in August?
You what?
Like in August, is it high?
Oh, in August, yeah, it's really low. So usually about August 15th is when they'll cut off the dam.
Yeah.
So it's usually not tons of water, but it's usually above 750 about. And then August 15th, they close that dam. And then it will drop dramatically. So by, you know, August 18th, 19th, it usually takes a couple days to really affect it. You can easily go from like 750 down to like 300 real quick, especially like in a drought.
That's right.
But, yeah, Twin Lakes.
Twin Lakes.
So,
when the season over, though.
Some guides, I've rafted through October before. I think October 20th is my latest commercial trip. Which is pretty late. It's mostly weekend. Let's go forward one. I would say September. I think early September is when, let's go forward one. One more. That's when, the bar and grill shuts down. And it's definitely quite a bit slower. Yeah, I'd say May through September. It's pretty much running trips for sure. Sometimes though, we've even taken people in March.
Wow.
Yeah, it can be pretty cool, especially if the weather. I mean, I've been snowed on, or rain that freezes as soon as it hits the raft.
Yep.
Those are pretty much. Yeah,
you don't.
See one of our extreme zip line towers there on top of the straight ahead up on top of the mountain. This over here used to be some kind of glass factory, I guess. So the 70s, 80s. Apparently they mine the silicas right out of the little quarry back there.
So if you ever
and this is really where you start to see the uplift that created the gorge. So geologists believe that this was basically the beach. Canyon City was a beach where there was a vast interior inland sea, and then something underground changed, volcanic activity and shifting, and it just forced all this Precambrian rock up and over kind of on its side, and that's kind of what this is, where it started to rise up, and then as you go, you get into the gorge, so you're where the bridge is, where it's just straight up, over 1,000 feet, just fallen rock walls on both sides. One of the sketchiest parts of the river right now down there in the Narrows. You get all this water going through a gap maybe 30 feet wide. Still forward one. It basically turns into a funnel. So constriction, downhill gradient, and the boulders, those are the things that cause the rock. And the gorge is about twice as steep as what we just did. Forward two.
Same river as the gorge?
Same river, yep. We're actually taking out where the gorge would normally start.
So what's the river called then?
Forward to the Arkansas River. Yep. Stop. Oh, good. Perfect.
Yeah, you just have sections.
Yeah, Royal Gorge is pretty much the last section and one of the biggest. Then you got Bighorn Sheep Canyon, which is technically 50, 60 miles long. We did about 14 miles up this road. And then when you get to Salida, you got Browns Canyon, goes from Salida to Buena Vista. That's a really good section of rafting, kind of like this. More scenic, I would say, without the highway, you got the pins through the mountains and stuff, and lots of pine trees. Pretty similar scale of grading of whitewater, a little bit more committed. But yeah, great section. And up above that is the numbers. The numbers would be more comparable to the gorge. It's actually closed, like the gorge is. Part of that is because of the bridges that you just can't get under. That's part of why the numbers are closed. The gorge closes mostly because about 6 of the 10 miles is just non-stop. Rapid after rapid. And if you swim, you can easily swim miles. Big class 4, class 5 rapids. That's why they shut it down. Based on state park's recommendation, and insurance says, yeah, you can't.
So why did they call this Arkansas for number 33?
Just when they were settling the West and Manifest Destiny and whatnot, they got out past the Mississippi and saw this river, and that's pretty much where Arkansas is. So it's a different territory. So they didn't really name a river the Colorado, so they got over the mountains, and then they're oh, look at this huge river. That's why they named it Colorado. The first is actually the Grand River. That's why it's called the Grand Canyon.
Oh, okay.
It used to be the Colorado and the Green River, where they confluenced, formed the Grand River. And then they decided that two rivers didn't make a new river, and one of the rivers was still the river. This is a gauge. This is where we get our reading right here. Takes a computerized reading off of that little dipstick kind of a thing, and then feeds it to a satellite. And pretty much every hour, about a quarter before the hour, we'll get a new updated flow.
and we're gonna make a hard push to the right here. Forward one. Forward one. Forward one. Forward two. Keep going. 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 Stop. Right behind you, Quinn.
Pretty good, heck yeah. Awesome trip. The wave harvest is good.
Gotta let a brother know. Cool. Good trip.
Yeah.